I've never actually used one of these before. Woo! Oh, that's pretty cool. I like that. I guess I can't pick that up. Oh, yes, I can. Mm-hmm. Ka-chow! Hey there, Foxy Gamers! Welcome back to Subnautica. I have some great news for you. We have crash fish powder galore. So much crash fish powder that I don't know what to do with because I only know of one purpose of it. So I have already made ourselves a repair tool, which is good because I also expanded onto our base and I totally wasn't paying attention to our hull integrity. And I, like, damaged the base because I overbuilt without putting in reinforcement. So fortunately, I had the repair tool and was able to stop the leak. So let me show you what I have done here. I have put in a little extra hallway right here. I don't know if this is, like, the best design or not, but that hallway, my purpose of that is basically just to put up more storage containers when we run out of space in this hallway, because we are getting close. I did quite a bit of farming in order to stock up on a few things, and I needed a lot of glass and titanium in order to expand this out as much as I wanted to. And over here we have a new double multi-purpose room, because we have our alien containment now. So in order to make this two stories, you have to build a multi-purpose room on top of the other one, put in a ladder, and build another alien containment unit on top of that one. And then you have to put a hatch on here so that you can get in. So now we have, I put in two creep vines in here, and then I just dropped off a whole bunch of eggs that we'd been keeping. I think, like, that guy's a crash fish, that guy's a the big gas butt, guys. Sand shark and maybe a stalker, one of those. Not sure what the fourth one is. But yeah, we're gonna have a lot of predators in our alien containment, so that is cool. I also want to get a brain coral sample the next time I see one of those, because Teon keeps bugging me to use those guys, and then I can plant them other places and, like, have oxygen wherever I'm, like, down below farming, so I don't have to worry about gathering pipes and all that. Alright, so I also have four beacons ready to go to the Aurora. We are stocked up on our food and water good enough, have a repair tool, our laser cutter, an extra battery and power cell. The survival knife is fairly alright, and I am now wearing the radiation helmet instead of the rebreather because we will not likely have to be underwater much going to the Aurora, but I do want to be radiation-proof until I at least weld up the radiation leak, which I'm not sure if I'm going to bother with doing that today, but we will do that eventually for sure. I'm going to eat one more of these bolo tree samples, and then, adventuring we go! Okie dokie, I also want to pick up any quartz that I find along the way, because I am completely out of quartz and glass, and I would like to do more things with that in the future. So, to the Aurora we go! Fingers crossed that we don't encounter any Reapers, because I would like this series to go beyond today's episode. But we shall see how this goes. I'm gonna do my best to stay near the shore, or, you know, above water, and, let's jump out and grab whatever's hiding inside this little rock. Just titanium, boo. And I will hug the Aurora as well, because those two things will probably minimize my chances of encountering a Reaper. We are at 42% energy. Actually, you know what? Just while I'm here, I might as well repair this. I know it's only 5%. Is that done already? Okay. Just because you never know, that 5% may change the difference of life and death when it comes to encountering Reapers. We have not been in this area at all yet because I haven't had a radiation suit, so as a matter of fact, we might want to check out this wreck here. See if there's anything of interest. I'm not sure. I have to be extra careful because of my not having the rebreather now, so I don't want to steer too far away from our sea moth. Not too big of a deal there with the chair. It's kind of fun, but it'll probably be a while before I have enough resources really to start putting in fancy stuff into our base. I do eventually want to come back out and explore all of these wrecks with a rebreather now that we have a laser cutter. Can we go in that way? Nope. But the laser cutter takes a long time to open a door, so we want to always make sure that we have enough oxygen to deal with that. And let's see. Can I cut open this door? No. Okay. Generally, you're gonna want to look for doors that look like they've been kind of burned. Those are the ones that you can- oh, sorry, little peeper. Those are the ones that you can cut open. I just thought I'd give it a try in case something had changed since the last time I was playing this game. But let's check out what we got down here. It's usually stuff inside here, yep. Ooh, great, a power cell. That is fantastic. Because I have not yet found the blueprints for our power cell charger. So we have to keep making those in order to not run out until we find that charger. Alright, it is approaching nighttime. I don't want to, like, hang out in this area at night just in case there are Reapers nearby. And then I wouldn't be able to see them if there were- ooh, that looks like potentially another wreck down there. Let's take a look. And I might just have to mark that for later. I think we're still okay from Reapers at the moment. It won't be till we get a little bit closer to the front of the Aurora, I think. Fingers crossed! We'll use the light of that to help us take a peek under here. Alright, we got a med kit. That is nothing there. No, I don't want the metal salvage. But here's another box. Okay. I feel like this is warning us. By giving us all of these med kits, it is like, hey, you're gonna need them, because you're gonna encounter a Reaper pretty soon. We will do our staying near the surface now for a while, till we get to the front of the Aurora. Oh, actually, but then there's more wrecks, so we'll take a look at these real quick first. Oh, there's a sand shark. Vehicle upgrade console fragment. Cool. Alright. Not too terribly scared of the sand shark, but he could become a nuisance if we are not paying attention. Vehicle modification station, which is great for whenever we get ourselves a moon pool, then we can start putting upgrades onto our sea moth. Ooh, propulsion cannon fragments. Yay! Cool. Now, where's our sea moth? That would be just like me to not pay attention to where our sea moth is and die of lack of oxygen. Don't ask why I waited this long to come over to the Aurora. That is a good question. Because I could have been getting all of this great stuff, and not have to be making everything myself. Awesome. So now we have the propulsion cannon as well, which would actually be good for me to have going into the Aurora, because there are certain doors. Whoops. I don't know why that opened up. There are certain doors that we can't go through without moving stuff out of the way. And you know, I might actually make a quick trip back to our base. I wasn't expecting to find this much stuff right away. And I know we're gonna find a lot of stuff when we go to the Aurora, and so I wanna make sure I have inventory space. I think this is just, yep, propulsion cannon fragment, but just double checking. Okay, well, I'm gonna run back to our base, and then I will cut the video to returning to where we are now. Alright, welcome back, guys. I also decided to go ahead and make a propulsion cannon while I was back at our base, because why not? So now we have all of the tools we need to get into the Aurora. Oh my goodness, so many supply crates. You know, I probably didn't need to be carrying any medic kits or water on us either, because we're probably gonna find all that stuff in these boxes, but better safe than sorry, I suppose, especially since we are playing on permadeath mode. So if my inventory gets full, I will just have to make sacrifices accordingly. I don't know how much this area has changed since the last time I played this game, if Reapers are more prominent in this area, or if they keep their distance in the north side of the Aurora. Or actually, that's not necessarily the north side, it's just the front of the Aurora. We'll double check everything in here. So many more boxes than I remember there being in this game. It's very likely that these things did get added in since the last time I played. Oh my god, so many batteries. Batteries are honestly pretty easy to make, too. Well, I can't get whatever's in that one, but I'm not terribly concerned, because it was probably another battery, of which I already have a million of now. And once you make all of the things that need batteries, you kinda don't need more than a couple spares, because you can just recharge them, and the battery charger is fairly easy to get. Although I will need them to make more power cells for things eventually, so maybe that's okay to have a few spare ones. Now I'm gonna try to sneak in over here so that I am less likely to find a Reaper friend. I'm gonna make a decision of where I want to park this. I don't think there's anything of importance down here. Unless, like I said, unless things have changed. Definitely want to try to not damage my Seamoth, though. Alright, so we are going to encounter these, yeah, these little fuckers. Here we are! Where'd you go? Come back here. Come here! Jesus, why can't I hit you? That's not fair. Cut it out. Alright, fine. Screw you. Oh god, more battery. I'm just gonna leave that there. We have like a million batteries already. Okay, and I need to remember, Jesus Christ, that the music is just ominous. It doesn't actually mean we're necessarily going to die. I kept thinking that, like, maybe the ship would crash. Come on! Or like, the ship would collapse while we were on it or something, but that does not seem to be the case. Water? No. I just don't want to waste my inventory space with that now. Come here! Fuck off! Thank you. Alright, let's give our propulsion cannon a try, shall we? I've never actually used one of these before! Woo! Oh, that's pretty cool! I like that. I guess I can't pick that up. Oh, yes, I can. Come on, pick up the desk. Ah! One more. Wow, that uses a lot. Hey, stalker egg discovered. Hooray. Oh, shit. I forgot that we need a fire extinguisher. Gah! Alright, well, I think there's one. There's at least one on the ship here. Oops, that guy's dead. Scared the crap out of me for a second. Ah, yes! There's one in the hallway. How convenient. Thank you. Oh boy, we're gonna have to deal with bleeders, aren't we? Shoot, I don't actually know what's in here. Oh, you know what? I didn't bring a flashlight either. Oh, bummer. We'll just have to use our... Okay, do I see bleeders? I do not, at least not right here. We will definitely be running into them later. I don't know how much of my health they take. Woo! This is kind of terrifying. I feel like I should be getting electrocuted with all these loose wires in here. Oh boy. That does not seem safe. Okay, we might check our PDA to see if there is, the door code. Whoops. Alright, I'm gonna have to pop up for some oxygen in a moment here. But let's see if we can get this door cut open first. Nope, cutting it a little close. Gotta remember I don't have a rebreather. Or any sort of extra oxygen tank. Alright, let's go check out what's behind door number one. Woo! Okay. I don't think I've ever been here before.
Aurora, T-minus 6 minutes. This is an emergency distress call.
Oh.
Aurora is on collision course with planet 4546.
Ooh.
Sending all available environmental data. Please find survival solution. ALTERRAHQ T+8 out to any survivors of the starship Aurora. If you're hearing this, we will do everything in our power to get you home.
Alright.
A rescue mission would take years to reach you out there, but we think we've got a better solution. ALTERRAHQ T+8 out. We received your environmental data, and we've sent you a blueprint for a specially designed ship we think will be capable of breaking orbit and getting you back to the nearest phase gate. We calculate that you can find the requisite materials in situ. We'll be sure to start it. T+8 hours. Communications relay offline.
Wow. That was a long thingy there. Check out our PDA and see what kind of stuff we just got. Code lab access 6483. Awesome. Aurora black box data. Let's hang out up here while we have oxygen. Initiated slingshot maneuver around planet 4546B. All right, that's what planet we're on. High velocity energy pulse launched from planet surface. Emergency distress signal sent to Altera listening buoy. Impact detected. Drive core shield compromised. Lifepod bays on starboard side compromised. Emergency evacuation initiated. Da 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 da. Okay. All just lots of warning. Oh yeah, I've been scanning a whole bunch of stuff too. But we already know about most of those things. So I don't know if there's supposed to be anything else in here. Oh, wait, that's right. Duh, we have a door code we need to use. Let's see. What was that? 6483. Okay. 6 4. Oh, this is hard while swimming. Does that mean it's unlocked? Yay! I'm still on the lookout for bleeders. I don't see any right here. That's good. I'm gonna pop up for some air before we go inside there because we don't have a good place to go. Hooray! Oh, that is- no. Okay, I thought that was scannable, but it is not- whoop, whoop. Pick up lab equipment. I don't know if I really care about taking up my inventory space with that, but there you have it anyway. Let's see. Databank corruption is detected on your PDA. Your technology blueprints have been updated. I think we already got the propulsion cannon, right? Sure, let's take a water and we'll go ahead and drink that. Is there anywhere for air in here? Yes, fantastic. Boy, I'm getting kind of lost, guys. I don't actually know where all this- oh, okay, we just went in a circle. That's fine. Alright, nothing more to see here. Oh. And run away so we don't get hit by the fire. Okay, what else was in that data download? Technical equipment, propulsion cannon. Okay. We already know about that. Okay, well let's go over yonder. I think that's where I was thinking of that we can actually walk up a ramped area into another room. And our goal here is to, let's see, I think we're trying to get the moon pool here. I believe that's something we can get. Among other things, like the prawn suit. And perhaps some upgrades. Yes, I see you. Hurrah! Hurrah! Come here! Why are you running now, little fuckers? Exploration is not advised. I don't know if the game is just trying to scare me, or if that's actually something that has changed in this game. I guess we'll find out, guys. Come here. Ha! Jesus Christ. Oh my god. They're swarming me! Ah, jeez! They're little leapers now! I don't remember them leaping like that before. Come back here! Alright, I got you. I still hear more, but that's fine. I'm gonna go ahead and use a med kit just for the hell of it. I know that it restores more than I had lost, but that's okay. Ah! Ah! It's like kind of the cutest scary noise I've ever heard. Jeez Louise, there's a lot more of these guys than I remember there being. Alright, I think I got them all. Ow! Yeah, that's right. Watch out for falling fire. I did not get them all. There's a survivor. Come back here. Oh my god! They're all over! Okay. Well, I just spent a lot of time fighting those guys off, but you don't need to see all of that. Okay. Put out this fire and have a go inside here. Ooh. I feel like there's gotta be something good inside that if there's a fire blocking it. Nope, just another battery. There is another fire extinguisher, or I saw one a minute ago. Not sure if I'm gonna need that or not. We are down to 23% fuel, but let's see, this is propulsion cannon. Systems are running on local reserve power, unable to remotely download black box data. Okay, I'm gonna leave that. No need to fill up our inventory with titanium right now. Well, let's see. Administration, cargo bay 3. Ah, yes, this is the way I want to go. Now, there is a trick for getting in here. If you don't have a propulsion cannon, you can do a little running, jumping type of thing to get in over here. But since I do have the propulsion cannon and it's a lot of fun to use, I'm going to go ahead and do that. Pachoo! Pachoo! Sweet! Oh, shoot. Did we get data for this? Well, let's try the same. Damage pattern is not matched any known offensive technology. I did not see the first of that. Nope, that is not the right code. Guess we don't get the same one here. Okay, I think there's another spot nearby where we get the code for that door. But that is going to be next episode, as we are already running quite long. But we made a lot of progress today, so thanks a lot for joining me, boys and berries. And until next time, stay foxy.